Welcome to the Bombad Cast.
This is it.
We're here.
We're here. This is so exciting. We've made it. We are at the Phantom Menace Media Blitz. I am so pumped to talk about this. So I guess we could give an interlude here. Welcome to the Bombad Cast. If you're first time watching, happy to have you here. Last week we covered, and I have a picture of the thumb, if I'm not mistaken.
Oh, bring him up.
Is this not? It doesn't load. Sometimes this app is just terrible.
This is just nothing is as embarrassing as just like bringing something up and it doesn't load.
Load. That's okay. We've covered up last week, which honestly,
much like the what I love is that we are both labeled as Jerry right now.
Yes.
Yeah. But execution of the expectations and like the cultural impact that they thought Marf Olymp was going to have, it didn't load.
But look, we covered Marf Olymp last week. This is all leading up to our hype about the Phantom Menace, and now we're covering what was a very interesting time in pop culture history, which is the media blitz of the Phantom Menace. And when we say media blitz, we're strictly referring to the mass amount of marketing, and not just marketing, but push for this movie that has never, ever been replicated. I will say with certainty there, and it never will be. And I mean that with my whole heart. This movie, and I was freaking 5 years old when this came out. I remember it. That's what's burned into my head.
Go to hell. Good night. No, I'm just playing. No.
But like, for real though, I absolutely adore this movie, but the marketing behind it is kind of what led to an unbelievable hype that I don't think this movie could really satiate. And that's something we can look at, so we can discuss. We're going to watch several different things tonight. We're going to watch interviews with the cast. We're going to watch commercials from this era, the Taco Bell, the infamous Taco Bell, KFC, and Pizza Hut commercials. We're going to look at the news coverage leading up to it. And, of course, the actual premiere of this movie, which is inspiring a video in my head for later use. But we're going to be covering an unreal amount of stuff from 1999. And like, it's weird because for those that don't know, Phantom Menace was like the first trailer, like the first big trailer that dropped like on the internet. Like that was a big deal.
I remember going down, this sounds like your grandparents telling you about them going to school in the snow, but I remember going down to my aunt and uncle's house because they had a computer and internet and loading that shit up on there took forever. The media blitz with this thing was insane. We were at a sweet spot. We weren't in late stage capitalism. We were in like the golden age of capitalism right there. It was the end of the golden age of capitalism, I would say.
Yes.
We'll talk about the merits of capitalism some other time. I was in that George Lucas sweet spot of 12 years old when all of this was going down, and it absolutely, I mean, the 80s and 90s were all about like basically selling everything to kids that weren't cigarettes. And even
literally
old kids,
literally.
But to listen, it's such a huge overarching subject that I'm gonna need a little help to talk about it tonight. So I brought along with me Mommy's little helper.
There it is.
Here we go.
Is it boxed? Boxed wine?
It's boxed. Look at this. It's boxed wine. Mommy's little helper. Here we go. Can you hear that?
I can actually hear it. It's kind of nice.
Yeah. It's wine. It's not. I'm not peeing.
He's drinking his piss right now. No,
it's healthy. I
start this off with the trailer that came out, and I'm going to see if I can look up the exact date. When did the Phantom Menace trailer release? So there was also a movie that was also that came out with it, if I'm not mistaken. And people would go
meet
see
Joe
this
Black.
Movie.
Yeah, that's See, I wasn't old enough to go because like the closest theater at the time that would have been showing that was like 30 minutes away from my house, right?
Yeah,
and my parents weren't just going to drive me to the city to watch.
So here it is. It was God, this is wild. I cannot believe that it's just like we have it now, but it was in 1998. And the exact date, let's see, I had it up here earlier. The exact date was November 18th, 1998. And so apparently this is a big deal because it released through iTunes. It says, by night we had iTunes trailers and sites like Ain't It Cool, but there was no Facebook, no Twitter, no YouTube.
I would watch this YouTube trailer Yahoo trailers. Yahoo trailers is what I always went to. Yeah.
So this came out exactly 6 months before the film's release, and this is the first glimpse of this movie that we got. We're gonna watch it right here, and I might tear up, but I'm not even kidding.
I love how old that looks.
Isn't that weird? Oh,
it wasn't
God,
this
so
quality when I watched it too. No.
It was green. Dude, look at this right here.
This was nuts. Yeah.
Look at that.
You refer to the prophecy of the one who will bring balance to the Force. You believe it's this boy?
He can see things before they happen.
He can help you.
The Force is unusually strong.
Shit.
He was meant to help you.
Anakin! Tell him to take off!
Will I ever see you again?
What does your heart tell you?
Are you sure about this? Trusting our fate to a boy we hardly know?
Anakin Skywalker, meet Obi-Wan Kenobi.
I sense much fear in you.
The boy is dangerous. They all sense it. Why can't you?
Fear is the path to the dark side. Fear leads to anger. Anger leads to hate. Hate leads to suffering.
Oh, what's so crazy is this is before there were trailer. Like, I wish we could explain this to kids. This is before. Exactly.
I was going to say, what if in that shot we saw that? Yeah.
Coke Death Star getting blown up. Wait, it's this shot. Hold on. It cut.
Yeah. This is tense. It's that shot. Yeah.
That right shot there. Of an X-Wing. So this honest to God, like this trailer is before the craze of 54 Easter eggs you missed. Like, you had to have this conversation with your friends. That was the kind of things you had to, you know, discuss. You didn't have people to explain it for you. You had to do the digging yourself. And even back then, it was still super vague, you know?
Oh, totally.
This just started it all, man. This kicked us into the prequel trilogy. This is the first glimpse we got. And it's Gungans.
And I mean, they really leaned hard into using the actual John Williams score from
original
trilogy in this too.
So yes,
in this and in all the trailers, actually.
Yes, because for those that don't know, the score was recorded like in March of 99, like the end of March. Yeah. So they hadn't actually done. Apparently, the last edit on this movie was done like a night before it came out. Like a literal night or like two nights before it came out, the final touches. So like being able to appreciate this movie now after being 25 years of it being released is so surreal because groundbreaking. I mean, everything about this movie was groundbreaking, not just marketing, but like truly the effects that had never been done before. Nothing had ever looked like this. Look at that. completely just, CG. I mean, oh,
it was. I don't even. And again, like I said, watching this, I was. It wasn't this clear on my aunt and uncle's computer, but man, just to see this, like, and I had just gotten hyped about Dubak's being in the special editions, yeah. And to see the Dubak walk behind them, I was like, oh, there it is. There's the
there it is.
I don't know if I even knew what Dubak was back then. Maybe I did. I probably did. I had a Dubak toy.
Yeah,
but just. Man, I just see wonder kind of all of this, the detail and the just like trying to figure out what everything was. Like, it was just so you had the like, and you had R2-D2 and stuff. Like, it looked kind of like similar, but it was like, what is going on? Like, what Look is this shot. Now? Like, what God, is this world? Nice. There's no empire, there's no nothing, right?
Yeah, the puppet Yoda.
The first Yoda, book, yeah,
the Jedi Council we've been promised about for years. Like, I understand. And I mean it when I say this. I understand why people were actually disappointed, you know, for the most part. Like, I understand why some people are like, what? Like, I did not expect this because it is so different than the OT. And,
yeah,
you know, I do like that this trailer kind of sets that up. You know, you've got Jedi, a lot of Jedi. You've got a little boy. You've got a race, apparently. You've got a guy with a double-ended lightsaber. Like,
yes.
God, it shows every major player, every one of them.
And it shows Jar Jar shocking his, like getting his tongue numbed.
Yeah.
You know, like shocking his head. I mean, this, it showed you what, like you did, like people were like acting like they didn't know what they were getting into, but they're like telling you. Like, yeah, what they were going to, like, this is going to be fun. This is going to be a lot of stuff that, you know, this is going to be for kids.
And it's funny, it's 16 years between the OT and this movie. And I like this. I love that that Brian asked this. Sky, do you have any other memories of seeing it? Yeah. I don't think I do. I told this, we were just actually guesting on a podcast, the Laughing Places official Star Wars podcast, Who's the Bosk?
Yeah,
so check that out whenever it comes out. Great guy, Mike. He's wonderful. But he asked a very similar question, Brian, and it was, My earliest memory of Star Wars is the opening crawl of the Phantom Menace and the pod racing. Everything else is sort of a blur, but I do remember watching the VHSs after I saw the Phantom Menace. So this very well could have been, and to my knowledge, it is the first Star Wars movie I ever watched. It was my understanding of what Star Wars could be, even at the age of 5. So, like, you got to think, you know, not the most accurate depiction for a little dude, right? So, I don't know. It not accurate, I'm sorry. Not I said that wrong. It's not the OT, but it was still just Star Wars, like it is now. It's still Star Wars,
right?
Yeah.
Well, and I mean, I actually did, like, I got started on the original trilogy. I think we were talking about that too. Like, I've got both of my sets. I've got the Faces edition and the Special edition, and then I watched them before, and then I went to see them in the theater. We've told you guys this stuff before.
Of course.
I went to see them for the special editions. And so, see, I had an idea of what this kind of was.
Yeah.
But it's just such a, but yeah, like I said, I was in that prime spot where I was like, I was open to something new. Yeah. And I've always been like, me and you have always been the kind of people where I don't care if you take big, I want you to take big swings. I want to see something I haven't seen before. I don't want to see the same thing over and over and over and over and over again.
Of course not.
Except for Ghostbusters. You can give me the same kind of like formula every time and I'll be happy. but yeah, I mean, it's just amazing that, I mean, this really did hype people. People were hyped.
Oh, yeah.
To no end on this trailer alone.
This is the first step of that hype, which is why I wanted to bring it up first. Hey, Quinn, what's going on, kiddo? Glad to see you in the chat hanging out. We're talking about a movie that is probably, God, that's a crazy number, probably like 15 years older than you. So that's upsetting, let alone.
Yeah,
exactly. So it is what it is. But
I think I'm dying.
But yeah, like, looking at this movie now is just so incredible. Because it still holds up. And I wanted to say this too before we moved on. This movie's special effects was to the 90s what Star Wars was to 77. Like, it's changed it. movies after this. There is a period with movies before this, movies after this. The movie, this is so surreal. If you saw The Matrix in March of 99, you saw this trailer before that movie.
Yeah.
How nuts is that?
It's insane. And I mean, you know, this, like you're saying, is to what Star Wars was for 77, but also like it is like there was nothing like this again ever until like Avatar
came out
and everything like that. Like this was like the peak.
10 years. 10 years. It took 10 years. Transformers was great. I mean, there's a bunch of really good ones.
I was gonna say Jurassic Park was pretty badass. Like that one holds up too. But I mean, it's the same. It's ILM. It's all ILM, baby.
Yep. And I completely agree that this is such a good point. Brian needs to be our third host. Beginning the whole song with episode 4 was a brilliant tactic. Because then when you watch it, you go, oh my God, there's 3 before this. How does this happen? You know? And you know what? Eric Elliott, I don't know. Because they were both groundbreaking. And it's funny. Another funny thing is the next character to be a fully CGI character, of course, was Imhotep from The Mummy, which was a few months later. After the Phantom Menace. So then you've got The Mummy, which is also a groundbreaking action, you know, archaeological film. So like these are the three huge movies of this era, The Mummy, the Phantom Menace, and The Matrix. Like they're synonymous. They're all so important for the year 2000 and the following years to come after this in terms of visual effects and movies. Yeah. So like, it's remarkable.
Will is right. Lord of the Rings came around 2001, and it was pretty crazy. It was pretty cool too.
But the thing is, this walked so that movie could run. And I mean because the Battle of Naboo, literally Peter Jackson said that inspired the entire opening of the Lord of the Rings, the Fellowship of the Ring. Because they saw that you can do this now, then Weta said, okay, I guess we can really do full armies, full everything, because this movie could do it, you know? And I'm not saying that was the sole creator of special effects. What I'm saying pivot. This is a moment where you go, oh, wait a minute. Fully
George
rendered
was flexing.
Yes, seriously flexing. Fully rendered locations and scenes, like that had not been done before at all.
By the way, is it today Ken's birthday or is it tomorrow?
Tomorrow's Ken Nutsuck's birthday.
Oh, I was gonna say I saw his birthday stream thing there. You should really be checking out Ken Nutsuck. But we're glad you're here. This really kind of started some pioneering for a lot of things. I mean, like, sure, people talk about Gollum being like one of the first, like, you know, motion capture people. I mean, they weren't necessarily doing motion capture, but a very proto version of that with Jar Jar here. And so
pretty much
anyway,
so fascinating.
Yeah, no, this, it's just really great. We'll talk about the Phantom Menace the whole time, like the actual just movie, the whole time. Cause we just love it.
We do love that movie.
Oh my goodness. Okay.
So here's
the cans. Some... Marfalump was hawking.
So what you're about to watch is called The Media Blitz. Now, we're not going to watch the full thing. It's kind of low quality, but it is kind of a coverage of every aspect of this movie's release in terms of its, you know, in terms of the era it came out, the marketing for it, direct interviews with certain people that were obviously huge actors and actresses in the film. But the news coverage is what interests me the most, and the hype leading up to it. I mean, there was an unreal amount of hype. We'll watch some other cool stuff with it. So we're going to check out a little bit of this, and then we're gonna flip and move around because this is the Media Blitz, baby.
Got collectible cans to partner with the film.
It's gonna be starring all of the characters or all of the main characters from the movie.
It's just gonna do that. It's a VHS.
I was gonna
say, this is Access Hollywood.
Job of the Hutt, R2-D2, to the new creatures like Darth Maul and Jar Jar Binks. The first set of cans hit shelves this week. The Star Wars craze has gone automotive. $55,450 is the minimum bid on the internet for the Star Wars Trilogy Special Edition Hummer. By the way, if you bid and lose, you're out of luck. It's one.
What is this? Was this a thing? It was
I don't remember this. I was too young. I was too young for the Phantom Menace Edition thing.
Special Edition Hummer? What? Is this a real? I'm looking this up. Yep, this is a real thing.
That's well, Scotty just found his next car. That's gonna be Scotty's toy.
I don't know if you can buy. Look, I can show it to you. Literally, look at this. This is real. Lot 411, 1996 Hummer H1 Star Wars convertible SUV. Oh my god.
1996? Weird.
I don't even know what I'm looking at. Look at this. Is that really a thing? Yeah, look, it's the
what is it got on the side?
One of a kind Hummer H1 was the Grand Prize at Taco Bell's Feel the Force contest. Is a licensed Lucasfilm collectible created by Pepsi. It was featured in national commercials advertising re-release of the special edition trilogy and the contest. It was also pictured on the 6-foot-tall standee in the Taco Bell restaurants. This may be the ultimate Star Wars collectible. The sun visor is signed by the cast of Star Wars, including George Lucas. It has 14,919 miles on, and it looks new in every way. And it's a 4-door convertible pickup model, which is the most desirable Hummer body style.
Yeah, Someone owns it.
We have to register.
What's on the side of it? What's on the side?
I'll pull it up. It's it appears to be some sort
of HistoryChannel.com.
Is this the inside of it? This looks so industrial. What is this? Here's the
full. It looks like you're piloting a yacht or something. Oh, it's got Darth Vader on it. Okay.
It says Fuel the Force. Well, this is a real thing that I was not aware of. Look at that. You are piloting a boat. Look at this.
Yeah, it looks like you should be called Skipper if you're driving that thing.
Can we just use our Patreon money and own this?
Yeah, you guys go to our Patreon. Listen. Maybe we'll actually make some Patreon content if you guys pay us enough to buy this Hummer.
We're working on that, by the way. For those that don't know, we're trying to figure shit out. We really are. It's been a struggle. We've been so damn busy. I want to die. Anyway, let's keep watching this.
What do you want?
And speaking of one of a kind, he was born race to the box office in movie history. Star Wars Episode One: The Phantom Menace is expected to break every record.
Space race.
We can personally tell you it will. So how do we know? We've seen it.
It will.
Outside, the marquee said the Matrix was playing, but take a look at the extra security. What's the deal? It's all because inside this New York theater last night, a different sci-fi spectacular was showing.
Oh, are we going to see the lines
Access
around
Hollywood
the block?
Received these invitations embossed with an ultraviolet security code to see Star Wars Episode One: The Phantom Menace. And Access Hollywood film producer Melissa Prevel reveals that the hype was totally justified.
Totally. This film has stuff for everyone. I think the girls will love Natalie Portman because she's not just this pretty and proper queen, but she's as tough as any of the guys.
Back when they gendered everything.
And it's total girl power. Also, the
from toys, yeah.
Total girl power.
Yeah. Our resident Star Wars fanatic, Jim Kiernan, who's seen the original Star Wars more than 30 times. Jim, get a life.
And whoa! 30!
Jim, get a
life. I've seen Ghostbusters Frozen Empire 10 times, asshole.
Compared to this film, George Lucas took everything that was amazing about the first three, the effects, the action, the characters, the plot, and took it up at least 10 levels.
Even if you've never seen a Star Wars film, have no fear. There's no problem understanding the storyline and who the characters are. Speaking of characters, little Jake Lloyd as Anakin Skywalker steals the show.
Not only is Jake adorable, but he totally has what it takes to carry this film as a future Jedi Knight.
Wow.
Look
at the hype. Unbelievable.
And Jake Lloyd's spectacular performance was also seen by Rosie O'Donnell, who joined Access Hollywood at the screening last night.
Rosie.
On her show today, Rosie gave a big thumbs up to The Phantom Menace.
So excited. The greatest. I loved it.
Okay. She's doing it from behind Anakin's pod, which is something we all need to
Anakin's
take in.
Pod,
we saw this last week. We talked about this a little bit last week on a little private call between Jerry and I. Well, we're going to watch the Rosie interview with George, too.
It was unbelievably brilliant.
Yeah. Director George Lucas was a guest on today's Rosie show.
Wow.
O'Donnell went all out by replacing her guest with a Phantom Menace pod racer. Lucas's appearance on Rosie is just the beginning of a big New York media blitz.
She was about to kiss him for a second there.
Anytime soon. He has another Star Wars movie to write.
When is the next film?
The next film, unfortunately, is in 3 years. I wish it were four, but as soon as I finish all this week here in New York, I've got to go back and start writing.
Wow.
And just go right on to the next one. I'll be working on the next one before this one even comes out.
Oh, that's amazing.
That's a good look, Brian.
Yeah, it is.
That kimono is underrated.
Tomorrow we bring you all the Star Wars secrets from the master himself. We will sit down for a one-on-one interview with Star Wars creator George Lucas. How about that countdown? Huh?
Oh, that sounds really good. Yeah,
this when George was excited about doing this stuff,
dude.
Too.
Yeah.
Like, he was. I won't put me in there, but like, broke his spirit.
Yes.
Mainly the shitheads.
Yes.
That'll definitely
finger flick.
Two thumbs up. This is a major production.
Let's give them hell.
Thumb Wars.
Major.
Steve Odenkirk. Oh my God! Isn't that Bill's brother? Hold on.
I don't know. This guy did I really enjoyed, and I don't know if this is a good movie anymore. I haven't watched it in years, but in high school, one of my favorite movies was one of his movies, and it was Kung Pao Enter the Fist.
Okay, so apparently him and Bill Odenkirk are not brothers. I thought they were. They look very similar.
No, this guy has done a lot of. He did the Barnyard Show for Nickelodeon.
Yes.
The
Jimmy Neutron movie as well.
Jimmy Neutron. He wrote a lot of children's books and stuff too.
Yeah.
I haven't seen if Kung Pao. I don't know if that's good or not anymore. But
probably not.
But yeah. Anyway, he did the thumb Major thing special. With the tongue. I don't know if you've seen that movie.
Well, he's got this.
This is big. This is real big.
I'm sorry, what was that last part?
When it comes to Star Wars spoofs, this TV special is all thumbs, literally. It's Thumb Wars, a hilarious new parody dreamed up by writer Steve Odenkirk.
Okay, now I'm going to give you a sneak peek of the behind-the-scenes interview.
The hype is so absurd.
Check it out.
There's one I forgot, just remember.
Okay, we're going to need a little energy here.
Yeah.
Let's,
There's one I just remembered, though. I'm going to get pulled up, too.
That's it. Easy on the thumbnail. Easy, less cuticle.
Very loosely based on the original Star Wars trilogy, Thumb Wars features characters
I'm skipping
like
past
Princess
this.
Funhead
this is so
yeah,
stupid.
We can...
Roadrunner.
We have Ubi-Doo Banubi is a wise old thumb.
Ubi-Doo Banubi.
Thumb Wars Tuesday, May 8th. The four different ads are aimed at four very different groups of potential moviegoers.
There are things I cannot do.
Oh, the toad poems.
There's Queen Amidala, whose strong will is appealing to young women. Shmi Skywalker is the mother who must say goodbye to her son.
Don't look back before you go. Before you leave.
Children will identify with Anakin Skywalker.
It's insane how much they used.
Unbelievable.
All they did. Can you imagine them making toad poems today?
We'll watch those toad poems. They're actually really cool.
Jan ponders the choices that determine our destiny.
Oh, they're good.
Choice is yours alone. Do what you think you cannot do.
The ads will appear on television starting this week. By the way, Star Wars is so huge that two other films are moving further away from the opening. John Travolta may be a monster of a star, but his next film,
General's
Daughter, is being pushed back a week. And the animated South Park feature has been pushed back 2 weeks.
I did not know that.
Listen, they won an Oscar for Blame Canada.
They did.
The movie, can you believe
the music,
it?
The hype, the hoopla, the buildup, the countdown,
the hoopla,
plot, the stars, the wars. George Lucas on the movie of the century, right inside your television, from us to you.
Movie of the century, man.
Dude, it was though.
They absolutely just shot it through the roof, man.
It's insane. It's absurd how much this view time this movie got, in terms of like just marketing.
Today, a rare Star Wars treat. While the new movie's hype machine
you couldn't avoid it.
Crank it at full speed.
No,
I was a kid, and I could tell you I couldn't avoid it.
The real star.
I am loving this tracking. This tracking stuff, by the way.
You never
there
saw
it is.
Their faces. They never spoke a word, but the characters they played are loved throughout the world.
I'm gonna skip past this, but it's everyone just like, hey, remember Star Wars? That's pretty much the whole entire thing. Oh, look, here's, if I'm not mistaken, like immediate reactions after the movie. Let's see.
Oh, here we go.
Kathy Lee Gifford has another one of those in-depth interviews. And during
maybe we'll see Pete Fletzer of ATG Cast in the background.
Yes. He was in the New York premiere.
He was in the New York premiere.
Now George Pinocchio's in New York to review Star Wars, The Phantom Menace.
George Pinocchio. Sounds like a Star Wars name.
Was it Captain Panaka?
Movie fans know what I'm what talking about. Like. The new Star Wars movie, The Phantom Menace.
I love the
Tucker
gold
Carlson?
Logo.
But
some people got the chance to see it tonight.
Dude, that gold logo was everywhere.
Oh, it's so sexy.
Seen the movie. He joins us live from New York City tonight. George, what do you think?
Here we go. Well,
George, what do you think about green M&Ms?
Especially if they're Star Wars fans. But let me start by saying this. A lot of people, especially in our newsroom, when they saw the trailer alone, they thought the film looked pretty awesome. Well, just wait. Visually and technically, this film is remarkable. And the movie's new creatures are pretty cool, too. This is what I call cinematic eye candy.
I sense much.
In my opinion, the trailer for Star Wars Episode One, The Phantom Menace, only scratches the surface of what you'll see in the movie. There
wow,
are some amazing
okay.
technical moments. The film's visual look also gets high marks from moviegoers who attended this exclusive sneak peek.
I like the characters and the aliens. And I didn't think it had enough space action, but I like the lightsaber fight.
The special effects was awesome. George Lucas. Thumbs up. I give it to him.
We saw this last week, didn't we?
Yeah, we watched.
Diehard
we watched
Star Wars
together.
Fans probably had no problem following
oh,
the film
right.
storyline, but some moviegoers admitted to me they did, and one junior critic sounded like
oh,
he's been voicing
watch this, y'all.
For years.
I thought it was okay. I didn't think the humor was that good. It was a little bit childish. I liked the special effects, and I liked how it led up to all the other Star Wars movies, so all the other Star Wars movies made more sense.
But you say it was childish. You are a child.
Well, I'm almost a preteen, and I don't like to look at myself as a child.
With all the
damn.
This
yeah, well, you know what? Your bowl cut looks stupid, you little asshole.
That was your most Bill Murray thing you've ever said. Well, you know what?
Well,
yeah, you
think the acting here is good, but the special effects are better. Oscar caliber, as a matter of fact. While the Phantom Menace
like
is not
think
my
of myself
mother's
as the
movie,
new Bill
a lot
Murray,
of moms
actually,
and dads
sometimes.
Will be taking their little ones to witness the wonder a lot of us witnessed with the same amount of Star Wars excitement.
That's us, though.
Years ago.
Think about that.
Yeah, that was
the
us.
The little ones. That was us.
I was, he was, that kid was almost 13,
was
right? Is what he said?
Yeah, huh?
That was me. That was me.
That
was that kid's age.
George Pinocchio, ABC 7 Eyewitness News. Now
George
back to you guys in the studio.
Right. George, that little boy's thumb was
Captain
not
Pinocchio.
Like reaction,
yeah. Call me a kid, pal.
Put you in your place. Thank you, George.
And Liz Taylor plots a major career.
The cuts between
our studio, hilarious.
The cuts are insane.
One is ready for takeoff.
They just literally
the
ripped
film,
a VHS on here, didn't they?
Yeah.
For another big night, Sunday's official Hollywood premiere. So what's a 10-year-old do to get
George...
ready for his biggest walk down a red carpet yet? Find
Wait,
to
you?
Wear?
It's a big deal.
Eric, explain yourself.
You know?
I miss George's smile.
No, I think he meant George Pinocchio.
Oh,
yeah.
Never mind.
I
just miss George Lucas smiling.
And this young actor who plays Anakin Skywalker
like a sad bullfrog now.
Is suiting up
oh, look, he's getting his drift.
He's the one that I'm gonna wear for the tuxedo. You either look good or you don't. But you have to look good for a premiere, you know?
DKNY,
you
know, man. 10,
but this 90s.
Support.
Yeah.
We took Jake
God.
Designer, DKNY
wow.
Kids in New York City.
Jake, we love you.
Company president Wendy Shabani.
Do
you ever
you.
See
Jake,
this? We love you, man. You
so Jake, best. Jake, obviously, we can say this here. Clayton Sandell, a friend of ours, who works for, I believe it's, is it Newsy? I have to look it up. I don't want to make a mistake on saying it's been wrong. But our friend Clayton actually was the first person to get an exclusive interview with Jake Lloyd since like 2012. So go read that.
Well, with Jake Lloyd's mom.
And it's, oh, sorry. You're right. It was his mom, which did have a picture of him holding. I think it was an Ahsoka figure, and he had been watching.
It was.
Of course, the Ahsoka series.
Still a Star Wars fan after all these years. It was so heartwarming, and you know, our hearts go out to Jake and
of
everything
course.
That he's been, his family's been going through, and you guys are fucking badasses, and we love you.
Yes, of course. Let's keep watching this.
Brian, I'd been a Star Wars fan since 1977, and it was 30 and 99. And when trade negotiations scrolled up, I admit I kind of went, huh?
Yeah, I'm sure.
It's understandable. Yeah, yeah.
The taxation of trade.
Yeah, preteens are trying to be like, except for me. I was the one preteen going like, this is fucking cool. actually, back then I was saying, this is fudging cool. No, but Brian did love it. Yes. Yeah. All of us, man, are spending money we don't have right now on Phantom and the Chip.
Jake is just terrific. He really understands what he wants and what he's looking for.
Human Tornado, that's Reagan.
Which I think is going to be great.
Reagan!
With the premiere just 5 days away, young Jake is all set for his big Jedi night on the town.
The drip.
After the suit.
Look at
on
this
the Ritz by Taco.
Hell yeah, bud.
Putting on the Ritz by Taco.
Jake, that's what I was going to wear. Now, Jake isn't the only young actor that has people buzzing about Star Wars.
I love the 90s, man.
Serious girl power. Her name
in ways. I love the 90s in ways.
Girl, Jerry, they just said girl power, word for word you said earlier. Some serious girl power.
They're talking, listen, is also a real we're going to gender everything. Like, this is back with it. Like, yeah, I mean, girl power was big in the 90s and stuff like that kind of a thing. Like, the phrase.
Yes, they say it. Listen.
That's what I was going to wear. Now, what? Jake isn't the only young actor that has people buzzing about Star Wars, because this episode features some serious girl power. Her name, Natalie Portman. Her character, a young queen. Her performance, proof that Star Wars Episode I, The Phantom Menace, is also a real chick flick.
I think this film, much more than the old Star Wars movies, are much more catered towards girls and women.
That's right. Did not Star see Wars it. I did isn't not just for it. Boys anymore. 17-year-old Natalie Portman brings a
awesome,
feminine
though.
Touch to the Phantom
Star
Menace.
Star Wars is not just for boys anymore.
Must defend her it never was. Like,
a course of action that will lead us to war.
Natalie told me that this time George Lucas made a fairy tale for little girls.
Visually, it's just so beautiful.
I mean, I love this, honestly, as a girl dad.
Beautiful paintings.
And they're all for
the costumes are very beautiful.
Everyone.
And there's a very strong female character in this movie.
And she's got a strong sense of style. Princess Leia only wore the one white dress, but Natalie Portman gets 8 stunning outfits to fit every girl's dress-up fantasy.
Oh, in the first movie,
guess. You know about hair and makeup, and sometimes it takes longer than it should. But this must have taken forever, right?
Yeah, it took about 2.5 hours to get into hair and makeup, and the costumes were pretty elaborate as well.
Was it heavy? Was it?
Yeah, some of the headpieces were very, very uncomfortable. Was it very heavy?
It's good for like the effect of the film, as long as it doesn't like give me brain damage or anything. I'm all for it.
Each costume was handmade by a team of 40, and on set it took almost that many people to maintain Natalie's regal appearance.
Changed the way I moved and walked and felt, just because I had so many people, you know, touching my face and my hair and, you know, my costumes.
Incredible.
You really
that.
Feel much more like a queen when so many people care about, you know, what you're looking like.
They care, all right. Queen Amidala's signature red lip dot may be the next fashion trend.
She looked 30 years old to me whenever I was like a 12-year-old.
Oh, of course,
in
of course.
Movie.
But she's only 2 years old.
Like now looking back, it's like it's so
she's
weird.
A kid. It's a kid, yeah.
You know, I had people touching me after a child. Minutes, but when it's white, you know, and then with red on the top, it mixes. Not a good and practical style at all.
That's 8
just
times the girl power.
Years old, and not only is Natalie
well, that's pretty
actress,
good.
She's also a straight-A student who lives, until now anyway, a perfectly normal life on Long Island, New York. She also plans to go to college. Now, tomorrow, getting Star Wars out, we've got the solution. How about exclusive clips and never-before-seen on-the-set footage of Hugh Grant and Julia Roberts
the hell is happening
on their new picture, Notting Hill.
Pause. What's funny about some of this is, like, this guy, it's like talking to your uncle who says he's into Star Wars.
Some jaw-dropping special effects like flesh-eating beetles and deafening sandstorms. The Mummy broke a box office record.
Oh, it was, I'm sorry, The Matrix, The Mummy, then The Phantom Menace. That's the title lineup.
Today, we can show you how The Mummy was made.
Wow. Jesus.
The Mummy special effects team is led by John Burton.
All right, why are we talking about the Mummy now? Okay. No, I love like the way he was talking about like Princess Leia wore the one white dress. It's like it's like talking to that one cousin the uncle who really likes Star Wars, who says he really likes Star Wars, but he's like very like casual about it.
Yes.
You know, things like that. It's like the difference between people like us and again. Everyone's welcome, and that's awesome, and I love everyone. But it's just funny. It's like listening to like one of my uncles like at Thanksgiving. Like, yeah, I remember when Princess Leia wore that white dress and stuff like that. That was a cool look. It's a cool look.
That was
now
cool
they get
look.
Girl
yeah.
power going on here with this. Yeah. Yeah. This is really this Star Wars is really for girls. Fans descended on
man's Chinese theater in Hollywood,
money and credit cards in hand, hoping to snap up advanced tickets for the sci-fi epic.
The first 7 days ahead.
Away with tickets is Lincoln Gasking, the 28-year-old internet entrepreneur from Australia who we've been following as he's waited in line for the
Lincoln Gas. Yeah, let's see how Lincoln's doing. Lincoln.
Hold on. She was about to say how long he's been in line and stuff.
Oh, sorry.
I don't think it was just
was...
7 days. But no, people were in line for like months, if I remember right.
I got to see how this guy's doing. Too.
A month.
The first man to walk away with tickets is Lincoln Gasking, the 28-year-old internet entrepreneur from Australia who we've been following Gasking. As he's waited in line for the last month.
Man, Chinese.
Oh, it was a month.
It's just like amazing.
Gas
and in New
King.
York, it was the same madness outside the Ziegfeld Theater as fans lined up around the block. But if you didn't want to wait in line and you decided to call the movie phone, well, you weren't greeted like this.
Hello and welcome to movie phone.
You were greeted like this. But it was just 2 days ago when
I remember movie phone.
Holy fuck. He is a big
Yeah, back
deal.
In the day, kids, you didn't have an app to check. You called a phone number and they recorded a thing. And when I worked at a movie theater, that like that's one thing that the assistant managers had to do was record the line. Playing this week, we have Red Eye at 1 o'clock, 4 p.m., 6 p.m., 7 p.m. Also 9 and 10.
Leek Gaksky is currently okay, so he's done a bunch of stuff. He is apparently
he's
big
still
in the
an
tech,
internet entrepreneur.
Still, but he had a name change. He's now goes by the name Link. L-I-N-C.
Link.
Right. Gasking. Yes.
Link.
It gets doxed him. No, he's doing pretty good. Apparently he works with a lot of AR augmented reality kind of stuff. That's what he does. He's,
oh, cool.
So he does
AI.
Say,
as long as it's not AI, he's probably fine. You
I'm
know?
Sure he does something in AI. I mean, all these people are going to start doing things in AI. Anyway, let's keep going. I'm glad to see he's still an internet tech sensation. He's doing
still
well.
Still kicking it around.
Yeah.
You two in the line got the biggest surprise of their lives when the movie.
Oh,
Ray
look.
Park, who plays the evil Darth
revenge
Maul,
porn, Ray Park.
Darth Maul seen here battling Liam Neeson.
Revenge.
Darth Maul seen here sharing a blowjob video of his girlfriend.
And Ewan McGregor in the film's key battle scene posed for pictures,
Jesus.
Chatted with fans, and even checked out a replica of the double blade lightsaber he uses
there.
In the movie.
Yeah, he looks pretty cool when I'm doing
he's
the flips, off. Right? Don't cross me. Don't cross me or have sex with me. Hey. No, not allegedly, Eric. Not allegedly. For realsy.
I don't know. I guess you weren't around in 2017 when he posted a video of his previous wife sucking his penis on Instagram, because that actually happened.
It like went that, everywhere.
Maybe it was 2020. It was soon after
listen,
he had his
we
role.
We can stop
in
talking
Solo.
About him if we want anyway, to. We can stop talking about Ray, Revenge Ray.
Star Wars fans, feel the force.
I love the VHS so
this
much.
This is so our aesthetic. So are we gonna make it through this video? How much is left?
We don't have to watch the rest of it. I just thought it was a good video.
I love it. I love it.
We haven't much time.
We certainly don't have much time. Just a week until the Star Wars prequel invades movie theaters all over the country.
All that waiting in line is beginning
weird
to
hearing just prequel as like a
one singular.
Those people will be moving from the line prequel. For tickets and soon be forming a different line to get the best seats at Showtime. Our Wayne Garcia is live in Hollywood right now. But the question just has to be asked, Wayne, what the heck and why are they doing it?
That is a question
Phantom
I'm afraid
fanatics.
I'm not able to answer yet, but I do have some details for you. We're here at Man's Chinese. I want to show you where the payoff area of the line is. There is the box office. That's
nice.
What people have been waiting about 8 hours for now. Robert's going to pan a little bit to his left here, and he's going to show you where the line starts.
Revenge porn.
Now, it's go back. You keep going around the corner about maybe 300,
wow.
400 yards.
Wow, I've been
from here.
There, and that
That's
is
where
insane.
You gotta go. Some people say it's worth it, but a lot of people say it's not.
Wow.
Once upon a time, in a neighborhood not that far, far away,
there you go. Yes!
There was a line.
Yes, I saw the line.
Yes.
And to some, this is a big mystery. Do you know what the line's for?
Yeah.
No.
No, not really.
People who passed the multitude stopped and stared. Some offered looks of
disgust. That guy in the cowboy hat's my new favorite guy.
Utter disbelief.
Forever.
At the line's length.
Very long. It's like way around the corner.
Of course, the force of the people in line had its purpose, but for many, it
was
just
there's lots of tea going on.
Oh, yeah.
People crazy because I wouldn't stand in that long line even if the movie was free.
Would you be caught dead in that line?
Yeah, right.
I wouldn't wait in that line.
Or anything at all you'd wait that long for?
I guess, yeah, for all this stuff.
How about a new house?
A new house, yeah.
Wipe them out.
How about a diamond ring, maybe, for your wife or girlfriend?
That, too. Yeah, I can wait for that.
Yeah, that, too. That, too.
Like that,
yeah.
This is a diamond ring for the movie.
It, yes.
We must do
this
something
like
quickly.
How about for a two-hour movie?
This is peak making fun of nerds, by the way.
Oh, yeah. Like, it was. 100%.
Like, at this time. This is like... People would go to the line to razz these people for like adults, grown adults,
incredible,
staying in line for a Star Wars. Because it was still back then. It was like you fucking animal, you funny little bitch. What are you doing out here? Don't you want to marry your wife?
Eric says he drops gems for correcting me. Gets attention. It's not correcting so much as it's not allegedly. That is not correcting someone.
Oh,
that is
not
making sure. Ray Park realized he screwed his whole life with Disney doing that.
So. I don't think so. I never do that.
Not even 10 minutes.
I think it's ridiculous. I mean, what's the big deal? It's just Star Wars. You can just wait till it comes out.
Listen here, woman.
But there must.
What's the big deal? This is the Phantom fucking Menace, man. Oh my God. It's the biggest deal. There's no
still
deal
people
bigger.
Like it's, I think that was my ex-wife, actually.
Yeah. What's the big deal?
Must be something to it. There has to be, doesn't there? Maybe all these onlookers are just missing the point. Maybe Star Wars is worth the wait.
It
at
is.
At least somebody's wait.
If you got time to stand in line, then maybe you should give me some tickets while you're at it. You know, so I can come in, you know, my 30 minutes before the show and I'm all good. Like that.
Back here live in Hollywood, we're told that a lot of movie theaters are going to be open for 24 hours a day for the first week or two while this is going on. Let's,
for the first week or two.
Here. Excuse me, sir. Can you tell me how long have you been in line to this point?
Honestly, 8 hours.
8 hours, but you're almost there.
Bad.
Is it worth it?
Like, I'm a bureau. That's actually not bad for a guaranteed.
Yeah, no,
ticket.
That's a. Listen, that's like some people have waited longer at Celebration for that.
Yes,
you know?
Actually. Like, for real.
Yeah, definitely worth it. I'm just afraid that I'm gonna have to wait another 8 hours come a week from now.
Now that could be
the
case.
Into the movie theater, we're told that three shows are sold out here at Mann's, but there's plenty of shows left to go. It begins at 12:01 a.m. a week from today. We're live in Hollywood. Wayne Garcia, Prime 9 News.
Just amazing.
Oh man, the days before assigned seating in movie theaters too.
Good lord,
crazy.
Hell, when I saw the Phantom Menace, there wasn't assigned seating. I'm sorry, when I saw the Force Awakens still. Like there was
yeah.
still
yeah
you know,
not everywhere yeah that hadn't been like
was
fully
for me.
Adopted everywhere.
This Access Hollywood's great. We're gonna shift gears a little bit and watch some other stuff that is from the same era that I think all of y'all will enjoy. One such in particular that most people don't even bring up anymore, though it was very very popular when it came out. Hell, even I was made aware of it, and it's a huge classic because apparently. From what I've been told, that Weird Al got all this information about the Phantom Menace just from the internet. He was not privy to any information.
When did the song come out? So the song came out before the movie, right?
If I'm not mistaken, it did. The song, let's see if it has anything on the song.
So I remember this song, seeing it like well after the movie had come out.
Yeah.
Like, it was years before I actually saw this music video.
Yeah.
Believe it or not. Because everything wasn't readily available at that time.
Of course.
But I, for one thing, just seeing this video and going like, oh, that's a really funny song. This song now has a lot more meaning, especially after the Phantom Menace panel at Chicago.
I got teary-eyed thinking about that.
To be in a room... with people singing this, it was just there was something just like transcendent about
it. We'll watch that video actually. Let's watch that video too. Here's we won't watch the full thing, but it's pretty incredible music video for 99. I'll look up when it came out.
Oh, wait, listen, we love Weird Al. I just purchased Weird, the Al Yankovic story on iTunes.
Oh, great.
I
need to
watch it this weekend. Fantastic. In a galaxy far away, June 24th, 1999.
This came out. 20th, 1999. Okay, no, I'm wrong. This came out. Oh, no, I'm right. This came out June 24th of 99, but it was recorded April 20th, 99. So this is all.
Yeah.
Like, it was written and recorded before. Look at this.
They lock the doors and try to kill us. We escape from that gas. Ellie loves this song, by the way.
Yeah. We took a bongo from the scene and we went to feed. I actually agree.
Is this supposed to be the Emperor?
That's Darth Sidious, who was not the Emperor.
Excuse me, the Phantom Menace. Yeah.
Look at this.
He does. Weird Al's a good-looking guy, right? Absolutely.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. He's just a small fry. Yes, he left
his home. That is Sidious. Saying soon I'm gonna be a Jedi. Soon I'm gonna be a Jedi. Oh yeah, these are the Cantina band. Did you know this junkyard slave isn't even old? God bless.
He can use the force, they say. Now Reagan's about to freak out when I pull this box of wine out that she hadn't seen because she got here late. But here we go. I'm gonna refill.
So Jerry and I are both at this panel, and this is a video of people seeing the saga begins at a Star Wars Celebration panel.
I heard how fast his pod can go.
God, that's so cool. Hold on. I guess we can find it. There's a couple videos of it. It was in the main room before the 20th.
And flying ace.
This is probably the best video we get. I'm going to skip a little bit so y'all can see it. But, like, the whole entire... I have a recording on my phone of it. This is not the right one. That's not the right hall.
It's not.
Damn, there is a video of it somewhere.
Yes,
I know exactly
what Reagan, I brought Mommy's Little Helper to the podcast. Yes.
Yeah.
To the live stream, to the podcast. The fuck am I on?
I can't find it. Oh well, that's okay.
Man, I have a video that's pretty great. We need to post some of our videos from the actual time.
God, it was great.
They're like, we got some great like in-depth stuff, you know, before we were even like really into doing this kind of stuff in this space, you know.
Of course.
Weird Al included it in his set at the 501st bash. Oh, I forgot that he was. Oh, Orlando. Okay, so he was at the Orlando bash.
Yeah, at the 501st bash. I remember that.
I didn't get to go to Orlando. Ugh.
What we're gonna watch now, and is you'll remember this, Jerry. I don't know if you watch MTV when you're that age, but there was.
I might have flipped past it, but I don't think Yeah, my parents didn't understand what MTV was.
Well, on. TRL, right? Is that what it was called? TRL? What was the
Request Live? Yeah.
Yeah. So
that's what that stands for, by the way.
This was requested like, I think, was it like 18 times? Like something ridiculous. I forgot there's a shirt that Brandon Renerdy made that's out there. I forget the exact number, but apparently it played for 18 weeks or something. It was like the most requested song for 18 weeks. Yeah. I have to look it up, but we're going to watch.
I'll bring more next time.
A little bit of this video, because this video is brilliant, because it ties the movie, the creation of the song Duel of the Fates, and like the concept art that makes the movie up all into one big bow. Rick is in it a couple times. Yeah, this is great. Ready? Here we go.
Wait, Rick is in it? I forgot that Rick was in it. Moranis? It's his birthday today, by the way. Happy birthday, Rick.
Look at this.
Beautiful.
Probably the most glimpses we got of the movie before the movie came out. Dude, look at this. This gives me chills.
That's incredible.
Yeah, I bet. Rick O'Lee? Maybe.
Look at this.
Ricolier? That's what I called him when I was 12. That's how I read that, Ricolier.
So for this song, movie, I think it's probably the best score that John Williams ever did. This is like the perfect score.
It's up there.
It's so triumphant.
Definitely up. Will bring balance to the
force. What's going on, Jeff?
You can see Jeff! What's up,
we're talking about your favorite movie, dude.
Yeah, talking about Rick Oil of L.A.
Jeff saw it in theaters, I think, 15 times, 17 times? Something crazy.
Oh, hell yeah.
Yeah, Jeff saw it a lot. God, this...
I'm almost there with Ghostbusters. I'm almost
Look
there.
At this. Doug!
Doug, you got to give Talk him a hug and tell him thank you for that.
Yeah.
The Yoda side-eye, man. That's got to be a gift.
There's Rick!
Rick!
Dude, the making of. Look at this. I am
Suck it up, Buck. Just kidding. I love this. It's just. Man, I just remember.
Look at
like,
Rick. The pods
it
are.
It just reminds me of, like, playing all these. I had just got a PlayStation 1. I had the Phantom Menace game, Jedi Power Battles. It just reminds me of, like, man, it was such a fun time.
It was. We're gonna watch some of those commercials actually after this. We watch the video games.
Fear. Fear attracts the fearful.
Had some. Oh, I didn't know they put those tone poems like they chucked. They just sprinkled
they
those
did.
Everywhere.
We're gonna actually we'll watch those next. Contact me.
The innocent. Or should we do an episode just on... No. Well, it will be fine.
Fear is my ally. And I can only protect you. I can't fight a war for you.
This is a battle I do not think that we can win.
I will sign no treaty, Senator.
You know what I love about John Williams is that he apparently still calls everyone baby and cat.
Oh, it's so cool. He's 90.
I would love to meet that man before he leaves this plane.
I'm gonna cry like a baby in May.
I just told Ellie we were gonna go watch this movie and she goes, no.
Kid, if you had any idea.
So we'll see. If Look she sees this. It in the theater, I just know.
Yeah.
Dude. Great cut. That was such a high fall. Fear in
you. Will I ever see you again?
Fear is the path to the dark side.
This is such a good edit. I haven't seen this in years.
This is not so much a music video as it is just a trailer for the movie, an extra long trailer. Or a supercut, or a fan cam.
Yeah. Holy shit, that was good.
Oh, yes.
Oh yes. My God. Unbelievable. Oh, and look, I found something that I never knew existed. You're going to love this.
Okay.
This is recorded off a TV. So, for those that don't know, we had the privilege to interview Seth Green, but we asked him about the MTV Skywalker Ranch screening. This is the only video I could find of this. But there is video footage of this day. We found them on Getty Images, but this is a Bombad exclusive that we found on YouTube that it has no views. It's got 700 views. Seth Green instantly. It's kind of quiet.
Mm-hmm. MTV private screening, baby.
Yeah, look at this.
If you lived here, you'd be in heaven by now. Hi, I'm
Chris Conley, and welcome to Skywalker Ranch here in Northern California.
What?
Where Star Wars creator George Lucas has put together...
If you lived here, you'd be in heaven by now.
Star Wars Episode 1, The Phantom Menace. Now, we are just moments away from a very special private screening of that much-anticipated film. And joining us to check out all the fun, only the cream of the crop from Hollywood and from rock and roll. We'll be talking to them as they arrive and after they've seen the film to get their reactions. Plus, we've got a lot of looks at this movie.
I've never seen this, so I hope we get a crazy drop. We know Ozzy was there. Oh, no, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Look, she's got the Gwen Stefani thing going on. The jewel. The middle of the eyebrows.
Especially with this fabulous list of people. Check out just a little bit of who's here. Korn, Limp Bizkit, Katie Holmes, Usher, and Seth Green. And that's just to name a few. We also have NSYNC, Orlando.
Seth Green. And right now, let's check in with nice guy, that Seth Green.
Yeah, wonderful dude.
Out at the New York benefit premiere of Star Wars Episode 1.
Backstreet Boys. Could be more 90s. Good lord.
Hi, we're the Backstreet Boys. Look at, I just am digging the red cowboy hat,
I
man.
Am too.
Celebrate the premiere of Star Wars Episode 1, The Phantom Menace, which is a benefit for pediatric cancer research. And that's what, one of the big reasons we're here. Plus, we're big,
oh, that's cool.
Star Wars fanatics.
Yep. George Lucas. Good job.
George Lucas. Good job.
Good job, George. George, you did it, George.
Who else is in this? Oh,
George is back. All right.
We should have pulled this clip.
Star Wars, like, to the max fan.
To the max? How do you define that?
I'm throwing back to the 70s there.
Oh, I like Star Wars. Yeah, I've seen me some Star Wars.
Of course.
Wow.
Usher Raymond in the house.
Usher?
How you doing?
I got you old school. Usher.
So young.
Usher got the beat to make your booty go smack, man. Come on, here we go.
When I was a little kid, and I really got to
barely remember it, though, do you?
Actually came out when I first, came out.
Right. You were birthed with it. Yeah,
you know, I was born
same age.
I was a star baby. Oh, yeah? The stoic face, tip it off. I can't.
Okay, Seth Green told us that those women were not allowed to speak. That was part of it. When we interviewed Seth Green, he was like, it was weird. Like, they had to stand out there all day, and they just weren't allowed to speak to anyone. And, like, it's so funny to see this footage now, because I never knew this existed.
Yeah.
God, this is amazing.
That's insane. That's insane.
Insane.
When was the last time you felt the Force was with you?
man, it's right
Katie's
now.
Going to bed.
All right. I know. We're going to bed soon.
Alyssa Milano.
Same thing?
Babe.
The buns are the Force, girl. So what are you most excited about seeing? I know we're all in the younger Star Wars generation.
I saw it already yesterday.
Did you?
Yesterday.
Don't give away any secrets.
I can't say anything.
So, okay, wait. Someone who's already seen the film. This should be illegal, but let's do it anyway, because I like illegal. No, I'm going to ask you to give anything away. Did you try to pick her brain in the limo?
No, I told her to be quiet.
Yeah.
And how do you think your lightsaber skills would be?
Wow. I'd probably be a blaster kind of guy, because the lightsaber, they do the swing, I'd cut my leg off. I'm the guy with the two-bladed lightsaber, that's swing that, foot gone.
The guy, wow.
Foot gone, yeah.
Fred Durst,
that's baby.
That's incredible.
Look at that. That's not a bucket hat, that's an actual bucket. Man,
Darth Maul, bad or just misunderstood?
So many single men owe him for that chin goatee.
Oh, yeah.
When you got the face with paint, you got the horns, automatically people are like, ooh, he looks different. He's a bad guy. The black, definitely confusing. So maybe he's just misunderstood.
Done with that. Have fun in it.
We're not the only ones with a special Star Wars Phantom Menace private screening today. NSYNC is in Orlando with a private screening of their own going on.
NSYNC.
I want
NSYNC.
More of this so bad. Okay, so
NSYNC's got a private screening.
Can we make a promise to our viewers, Jerry? Because I'm not gonna go to bed right now. My wife really wants me to. I gotta go and break down some DJ equipment so I can load it in her car. Viewers, would y'all be interested in watching all the commercials that we have cataloged next week? Would that be possible? Anyone watching live right now, to send us in the chat, because we will do strictly Phantom Menace commercials then, and we'll end on something pretty cool tonight if that's the case. Because if y'all want to watch us watch the commercials, we can do that. That's no problem. Because we can do that.
Half Moth says, is that yes to saving it for a full episode?
Yes, I think it is.
I think so.
Absolutely.
Well, I think that would be good because we've got a few more ideas for Phantom Menace. Honestly, we're going to have lots of Phantom Menace episodes.
I will show you all the things I have saved from researching. So it's about 4 pages worth of links that we've only
will there we've only be watched. Girl power?
I hope so. I really hope so. But we've got like news coverage, which we already kind of watched enough of today. There's one thing because they've got the toy coverage. You know, there's Rick McCallum. There's all the fast food commercials that we got to watch. So there is a lot more.
Yeah, we truly did. We may have false advertised with some Barbara Walters and some Rosie. Rosie was in the episode.
Rosie,
but you know what? We promised the hype. And God damn it, we gave the hype.
Yes. So. And we're going to give more hype next week when we cover the commercials.
Oh, so much more.
You want to do that?
Yeah, we've
that
got even more. Like I said, we've got even more ideas for little weird episodes about the Phantom Menace.
Of course.
That you guys will absolutely love. So yeah. we've got just content upon content upon content.
Don't think it's going to stop here.
No, absolutely not. Going. You There's think we can stop talking about this shit?
Nope, never. Like, here's never. Here's a Nabisco ad. Like, I don't know Nabisco is even involved in any of this.
Nabisco, I don't even know. It was literally everywhere. Meanwhile, I've been looking in every store around me, like within a 20-mile radius, for Ghostbusters Cheetos and have not found a single bag. That's how good marketing Cheetos. Is now. That's how good. Yeah, Ghost Pepper Cheetos. They came out like a month before the movie. Have not found a bag of them. So
nope, not anyway. Once.
No, not one. Whereas you couldn't you couldn't spit without hitting a Mountain Dew can with Qui-Gon Jinn on it.
No, there's no way. There's simply no way.
In 1999? No. It was everywhere.
Absolutely everywhere. So how about that? We'll leave you what we got already. There's things to look forward to. We'll do strictly commercials. I'll look down here, Jerry. Oh, I know he will. I know he will because he's got the VHS tapes.
He's got the hookup. He's gonna hook me up with some Ghostbusters Cheetos, I think.
Yes. Oh, I thought he meant some VHS footage.
From that's sure specifically Ghostbusters Cheetos, which I would love.
Could you imagine? Jerry just gets like a whole crate of Ghostbusters. He just saves them for the rest of his life. He just doesn't eat them.
Making a Cheeto angel.
Like and Jerry's last meal. It's like
I have like a
Papa. What do you want to eat as your last meal?
Give me the Ghost Pepper Cheetos. I have like a permanent like orange ring around my entire body.
Oh my God.
I have an Ecto-1 popcorn bucket, but I also have the trap from Frozen Empire. So anyway, we're talking about Phantom Menace, guys. We're talking about Phantom Menace.
We will have to watch one last clip that I think is very important to address something.
Brian says he might have footage too. So
I knew it.
Let us know. Let us know.
So
hi, Holly.
That's not Holly, it's Taylor.
Oh, wait, no, it's not Holly. Oh, Taylor. I'm sorry.
Wow.
Hi, best
friend. Queen of the pasta. Anyway, we're going to watch this. This is actually pretty cool that we can end on this, and then we'll do commercials strictly next week. Instead of media, we'll do Phantom Menace commercials. So this is actually very cool. This is George addressing toxic fandoms and 99. So let's see this.
All your characterizations are quite definite, aren't they? I mean, where did this one come from?
The movie is pretty neutral. It is in outer space. These are aliens. How in the world you could take an orange amphibian and say that he's a Jamaican? I mean, even the idea of taking his ears and calling them dreadlocks is kind of a strange stretch as far as I'm concerned. I mean, it's completely absurd. And what that came out of ultimately
interesting.
Was there is a group of fans from the films that don't like comic sidekicks. They want the films to be tough and like Terminator, and they want to be, you know, real guy movies. And they get very, very upset and very opinionated about anything that has anything to do with being childlike, which the movies are for children, but they don't want to admit that, and or a comic sidekick. They don't want comedy in these movies. And in the first film, they absolutely hated R2 and 3PO. Now Jar Jar is getting accused of the same thing.
Incredible, isn't it? It's so weird how 4K that image looks. I don't know who upscaled it, but like it looks sharp.
It looks really good.
Really good.
I love that Taylor did this Alex Jones quote, but it is a quote in Jared's Alex Jones voice. That's incredible. That is
God.
I honestly, like, I've never heard that first part, man, where he's like talking about, because to me, whenever people started saying like, oh, it's a real, you know, racist caricatures and stuff. And and again, white guy, I never picked up on it. Even like it always just felt like, I don't know. I never quite went to those depths. I never got
The character was played by a black man too. So like, there's like, So like, I don't know. I think it's interesting that, you know, and look, this is a controversial thing now. Then, and apparently it was then, which we will address. We understand that. We do get it. And people are entitled to their opinions still on this, but to hear the man himself like say that really was not my intention, and people are looking for that kind of thing, that's interesting. I mean, it is. It really is.
Yeah, it is. It's an interesting thing. It's an interesting thing. 100%. Absolutely.
Yeah. And there was one last one I wanted to end on that I completely forgot I had that you're gonna love. This one's a cursed commercial. This is actually a cursed commercial. I don't know.
Is this Liam Neeson?
This is insane. I don't know. I don't even know how to describe this to you. This is a actual commercial that, of course, I don't think so. I can almost guarantee you. I can guarantee you have not. I can literally guarantee you. Ready? Here we go.
Your training as an apprentice must include furniture shopping.
At Raymore and Flanagan, of course. Master, look, the surface links.
What the
But why shop today?
Through Monday, savings are store-wide, my young shopper.
That means you'll find savings in every department, including famous brands.
And their delivery force will be with you in 3 days or less.
May I help you with your purchase?
You can provide interest-free financing for 1 year.
Yes, 1 year.
Feel the power of store-wide savings at Raymore and
Flanagan. Is this saying she has a weak mind?
Monday.
Somewhere in the universe, the ultimate evil stirs.
What is
three
this?
Three legendary heroes have come together.
A preview for next
the battle
week.
To save the galaxy from the menace of the dark side. Right after lunch. Play Defeat the Dark Side. Collect cool Star Wars game medallions and you could win cash prizes. Even $1 million. Only at Taco Bell, KFC, and Pizza Hut.
I had so many of those little tokens.
Oh, what a wild era to like exist in, because they really there is something so interesting about that this actually existed.
What happens when the force of Star Wars Episode One meets the irresistible taste of Lay's potato chips?
I've seen this one.
Test your power to resist in the Lay's Star Wars Can You Resist game. You could win thousands of Star Wars prizes or the $100,000 grand prize. Look for game cards inside specially marked bags and Lay's chips.
The 90s is incredible.
Reagan, I don't know if this makes me want to never have furniture or have all the furniture.
Before you go. Oh, these are the tone poems. Actually, can we watch these? I think we can watch. Let's watch these real quick, because these fit more of what we're talking about.
We'll watch these, then we'll do commercials next week. So.
Yeah, that works, because these are very promising. So these are all the tone poems from 99, which, for those that don't know, these tone poems are actually kind of interesting. I think, to my knowledge, some of them use footage that is actually not seen in the movie, or longer cuts of scenes, if I'm not mistaken. I'm pretty sure I'm correct on that.
Which is the kid that with the tongue was in Star Trek Voyager? I'm sorry. I'm okay. Here we go. Let's do this.
Don't look back. Before you go, eyes forward. Choices to make. Dreams to realize. Don't look back before you go. Know the truth.
My mom shipped them so hard, by the way, in 1999. So hard.
Don't look back before you go. Before you leave me.
Ooh. That's a good one.
Yeah.
God, that's a good one. Jesus, this next one. This next one is... So that was Shmi's. So I think every major character... I don't know if Jar Jar got one. Maybe he did?
I don't know.
This is Anakin's. This one's actually kind of incredible.
What if dreams came true and you could be who you wanted to be? You could do what you wanted to do. And you could help who you wanted to help. What if
I thought Sebulba was pronounced Sebulba at this time. Up,
and you were never, ever afraid. What if dreams came true? But dreams do come true, don't they?
Fuck. that one's fucking good. Do you guys have them? Have the Motorola or was Nokia Phantom Menace print ads? Because I have all of them. No.
Reagan, you can text it to us.
Oh yeah, Ray. Here we go. Come on.
This is hard. Qui-Gon. Life.
One without reward, without remorse, without regret. A path will be placed before you. The choice is yours alone. Do what you think you cannot do. It will be a hard life, but you will find out who you are.
That's a different cut of that scene. I can actually guarantee you that shot of Darth Maul is not the one in the movie. Watch.
It will be a hard life.
It's way more centered. Oh, maybe it is. No, I don't think that's the same shot. There's a couple of these that I think linger. Look at the color grading on this. That is not the same color grading as we got in the movie. These high blues.
It's a little different. There's the high blue is a little off. Like the purple and the orange, they really played up. On the final cut.
That's in the movie. That's the movie. I don't think this exact shot. Maybe it is. Maybe it's flipped. Maybe that's why I'm thrown off. No, he's looking directly at the camera in this shot. That's not in the movie. He's looking more off.
Looks like he's looking off to me. But maybe I'm like. I don't know. I'm on my second glass of wine. It's only two. I'm only on two.
Bagged wine.
Yeah. Sebulba is what I thought it was. And then when I saw the movie, I was like, oh, it's actually Sebulba to one of my friends. And he was like, no, it's forever. I like Sebulba better. Like, okay. Whatever.
What will?
I was George Lucas to him.
I cannot watch while people suffer. I cannot sit when something must be done. I cannot judge those who are different. There are things I cannot do. Run. Hide. Ignore. There are things I cannot do. But there are certainly things I will do.
Ooh. Ooh, that was good. I like that. That was badass.
Not Natalie Portman. Definitely not Natalie Portman reading it, but still very cool. I don't know, maybe it was.
I think it was, honestly.
I don't know.
One truth.
Set it off to me. Maybe it was Cat.
Fear attracts the fearful. The
strong. Got chills.
The weak. The innocent.
This honestly sounds like Sam Witwer.
There's more dialogue here in the movie.
Fear is my ally.
Yeah, he says more words in here than in the fucking
movie. He does.
Absolutely.
Look at this. 2024. Oh, okay. That is Natalie's OG voice. Okay, yeah. This is fun. This is so cool to watch this, man. Oh, one
in a
only
palace
hope.
Of dreams, a queen stands alone. In her wisdom is the one chance to save her people. She is strong. She is determined. She is their only hope.
Cool. Okay, some Leia. One friend. Yes!
Sometimes, the one who's clumsy, different, or even a little strange, just might be the friend you're looking for.
I like that.
Serafinowicz was pretty good. I wonder if he would ever come back and do it. I know, like, they have, like, they've doubled down on Sam, like, so much, and he's still good at it.
Stayed alone.
In a time of change, a young man holds in his hands the fire.
Could have been
Keira
Knightley.
Age. To take the step from student to master, he must trust himself to stand alone.
Confirms.
Eric says audiobook voice.
Yes.
A little bit.
Yeah,
it's like AI
so
audiobook voice.
It's so interesting to see these tone poems play out.
Really,
you know, like it. What a cool way to do marketing, you know. I love that. Does Watto? Doesn't Watto? Yeah, Watto has one. There's no way this is real.
There's Watto. Oh,
there's no way. It says the long lost Watto TV spot. Someone made this.
Did Pete Fletcher do this one?
No, I don't think he did. Let's see. Wait.
Is this money? That is only money. No mind tricks. Money is more real. No money, no parts, no deal. Do I own a little Annie? Or does money own me? Money.
This can't be real.
Money is my money.
One currency.
There's no way that was real.
There's no way. There's Jesus no was like, what did dude, when it started out, it was like, money. I was like,
oh, Christ, man.
No.
One no. money. Oh,
yes, Buck, immediately. Immediately, I was like, this is. People want to talk about racism in the Phantom Menace. Like that. Right there.
I'm gonna go drop right a like right on there. That Watto video. Thank you, Will. Keep me in check, Will. Watto tone poem. I'm doing it. There's a like. There's that actually was, a subscribe.
Well done. Who made that? Let's get him on the show.
Nick Terse, which I believe is a Milky? Familiar name. No, Nick.
Oh.
Nick Terse also sounds super familiar. I don't know why.
Fred, Nick is it? Terse. Is he any like distant relation to Fred Durst?
No, it's Terse. What is this? Oh, he's like a Disney. He's like a Disney guy or something. This is very strange.
Really? Oh, let's get him on.
Only has 1,700 views. It should have more views than that. That was hilarious.
Yeah, that was great. We'll give that the patented bombad bump, as it's called. You know.
Oh man. Yeah, how exciting. There's one more we can watch that I think works. I know I keep saying there's one more, but this one's a good one. This is actually the VHS release. It's from a Hollywood Video. Jerry, did y'all have a Hollywood Video growing up near y'all?
Oh, that was the so for the last 10 years that there was like a video store in like it was all Hollywood Video. Like the rest of the places got shut down.
Yeah.
Our local place got shut down when Hollywood Video opened up. Right in front of Walmart, so they caught you right as you swing through right as you left with your groceries. You know,
you almost had
on a Friday night. You could go pick up your popcorn and like your pizza, frozen pizza or whatever, and you swing by the movie, Hollywood Video. I love Hollywood Video.
Yeah, let's watch this then. You'll get a kick out of it. It's actually very funny.
Now you can rent all new releases or anything else for 5 days.
Really?
Yeah, so you can just enjoy it at your own pace. At other video stores, you only get 1 day on new releases. So you can't enjoy it because you're too worried about getting it back on time. And then you gotta fly out the door in order to get to the video store before it closes. And the clock is ticking, the phone is ringing, the late fees are piling up so high.
He fucking died.
He's really into special effects.
Only Hollywood Video has Star Wars The Phantom Menace for 5 days, so you can watch it again and again. Welcome to Hollywood.
That was legitimately a funny commercial.
That was actually very funny. Just seeing one. I want to watch that one again. I like that one. He's really in the special effects.
It's like a that's almost a commercial that we would make, you know?
That's very good. Man, this has been fun. I'm glad we can look at the medium.
It's been a lot of fun.
Now you can rent all new releases or anything else for 5 days.
Really?
Yeah, so you can just enjoy it at your own pace. At other video stores, you only get 1 day on new releases. So you can't enjoy it because you're too worried about getting it back on time. And then you got to fly out the door in order to get to the video store before it closes. And the clock is ticking.
You bet
the
phone he is ringing.
Late fees are piling up so high.
Get the hide.
He's really into special effects.
Only Hollywood.
That is actually
It's the last guy. It's the last guy that comes. He's really into special effects. And then the blandness of the Phantom Menace. Like you, it's like it
five looks days. Like,
it's like written in Impact.
Oh, good lord! Oh man!
Oh, Very Buck! Buck! Hell yes!
You. Can we do a heart real quick?
I love you too.
I love you. I love you. See if you can do it. You gotta bring yours in
closer.
Hold
on the front.
Oh wait, here we go. Can we do it? We've never done. No, go down more. Go down more. You gotta go down more. Like go like bend your like shape your hand. There we go.
There. That's perfect. Ta-da! We love you guys. Screenshot! For the love of God, screenshot. All right. I'm done. I'm done.
Anyway. Everyone, chug the rest of your drink. Chug the rest of your drink. I'm about to go move some music equipment because I'm DJing this first school dance at my school in 25 years. Since the Phantom Menace.
Hell yeah.
It's a 99. Really? Yeah. Uh-huh. First school dance, middle school dance.
Absolutely incredible. Listen, I'm excited for the kiddos to have a fun time. DJ Jazzy Scotty.
It's actually DJ Bombad.
Rock the house.
It's actually DJ Bombad. I'm not kidding. Hell yeah. I put that on the posters.
Brand fucking synergy. And if we ever get a live show at a celebration, guys, DJ Bombad will make an appearance as well as George Lucas. And George Lucas will fucking dance.
And Paul Stanley.
Fucking dance.
Paul Stanley will make an appearance. Never know.
Yes, absolutely. Absolutely.
Thank you, everyone. Everyone stays bombed.
Thank
tonight.
You all.
I had a great time. Jerry's gonna sleep in. It's gonna be awesome. And
it's gonna be
I'm
great.
Gonna go
I'm gonna have two more
load music equipment to my wife's car because she has a bigger car than me. But anyway, read your versions of Simulacra and Simulation just because you need to get your philosophy.
We will discuss it next time. Yeah.
We will discuss it when we watch. Wait, is this all a simulation? Is the Phantom Menace real? You know, that's what we'll be looking at next
is
week.
Is it too good to be true?
Is it real? Possibly. Is it real? But anyway, Jerry, I guess we can plug that we're going to watch all the commercials next week. The media blitz has been covered. The commercials, video games, Taco Bell ads. I saw one.
There's so much.
There's so much. Nabisco. Don't know why. The Phantom Menace Racer Games. There's so much. There's so much.
I was going to say, there's lots in 1999. We can throw in as a bonus the Brisk iced tea commercials with not Ray Park, but Darth Maul.
Darth Maul. So. Yeah. Revenge Board Park. Anyway, Brisk, love you, Jerry. I love you. Park. Glad we get to this site, Jerry. Can we get a good stay bomb?
Ray please? Revenge. All of you out there, be sure you respect everyone and treat everyone kindly. Also, girl power, bomb girl power. Stay bombad, girl power.
Ladies, this is for the
stay
ladies.
Bombad, ladies.
Stay bombad, ladies.
Ooh, hang loose, ladies.
For the
stay
ladies.
Bombad.
Stay bombad, ladies.
Oh yeah.
Hey ladies. Hey ladies. Stay stay bombad, ladies. Hey ladies. Hey ladies watching in the chat. Stay bombad, ladies. Hey ladies. ladies. Do you like that, ladies? Stay bombad, ladies.
Stay bombad.
Stay bombad, ladies. This is for the girl. This is for the girls.
This is for the girls. This one's for the girls.
This is for the girls.
Yeah.
This is for the girls. This is for the girls. This is for the girls who don't give a shit, bro. These are the girls with the girl power. Stay bombad, girls. Stay bombad, girls. Stay bombad, girls. My wife just texted me.
Girls.
I'll let you read it. She says, please shut the fuck up.
Did you say impossible? Pasquale?
Only kidding, Jackie. I've changed my tune because I finally thought of a possible dream that we can all share.
What is it? Mr. Squally?
It's a dream about a world where nobody is poor or sick or hungry.
Oh, now that's a dream we can make come true.
I'm gonna make a change for once in my life. It's gonna feel real good. Gonna make a difference. Gonna make it right.
As I point up the collar on my favorite winter coat, this wind is blowing my mind.
I see the kids in the street with not enough to eat. Who am I to be blind, pretending not to see them?
Jim, we're still live. Do you like this? Do you like
Stevie this? Oba!